All right, Alexander, you said you saw something on Zero Hedge, that there are two more witnesses that are now corroborating the story from Tara Reid on Creepy Joe, correct?
Yeah, absolutely.
Let me pull it up. Let me pull up that article. And guys, we are also seeing this for the first time. All right. The title is Alexander, This Happened. Biden's accusers' sexual assault claim corroborated by two more witnesses via Zero Hedge. Let me read you the first couple paragraphs and see what you make of it. Let's see. Two more sources have come forward to corroborate sexual assault claims against Joe Biden by former staffer Tara Reid, who claims that in 1993, Biden forced himself upon her and penetrated her against her will with his fingers. Two people have already come forward to say that Reid told them of the incident shortly after it allegedly occurred. Her brother, Colin Moulton, and a friend who wishes to remain anonymous for fear of retribution. Okay, here it is, Alexander. Now, two more witnesses have come forward to Business Insider. Former neighbor, Linda Lacasse, a self-described very strong Democrat, and Reid's former co-worker, Lorraine Sanchez, who worked in the office of a California state senator in the mid-1990s. Interesting. This happened, and I know it did because I remember talking about it, said Lacasse, a retired former medical staff coordinator and emergency room clerk for San Luis Obispo General Hospital in California, who lived next door to Reid in the mid-1990s in an apartment complex in Morro Bay, California. Lacasse said she and Reid shared a bond because they were both mothers whose daughters swam together in the apartment complex's pool. In a series of interviews with Insider over the last week, Lacasse said she decided to speak up now, at a time when Reid's story is under intense scrutiny in the media and facing denials from the Biden campaign, because she believed Reid's account when she first heard it. Quote, I have to support her just because that's what happened, Lacasse said. We need to stand up and tell the truth. This is from Business Insider. Quote, I remember her saying, here was this person that she was working for and she idolized him, she said. And he kind of put her up against a wall and he put his hand up her skirt and he put his fingers inside her. She felt like she was assaulted and she really didn't feel there was anything she could do. She was crying, Lacasse said. She was upset. And the more she talked about it, the more she started crying. I remember saying that she needed to file a police report. I don't remember all the details, Lacasse said. I remember the skirt. I remember the fingers. I remember she was devastated. Now, Sanchez, the other witness who's corroborating the story, Alexander Sanchez told Insider that she recalls Reid complaining that her former boss had sexually harassed her and that after raising concerns, she had been fired. In an interview with Insider, the New York Times, the Washington Post, and politics podcaster Katie Halper, who broke the story of the assault allegations, Reid had said that in the spring of or summer of 1993, she was told to meet Biden in a semi-private corridor to deliver a duffel bag. There, she said, Biden pushed her up against the wall, reached under her skirt, and penetrated her with his fingers. When she resisted his advances, Reid said Biden expressed annoyance and said, "Oh man, I heard you liked me." Then she said he pointed a finger at her and said, "You're nothing to me." After that, she said he shook her by the shoulders and said, "You're okay, you're fine," before walking away. That comes from Business Insider, Alexander. Breaking news. What do you make of it?
Well, I think it's pretty bad for Biden, I should say. I mean, can I make a few quick observations? First of all, Business Insider is a pro-Democrat publication. I mean, we're not talking about a publication that's run or has any sympathy at all for the Republicans or for Donald Trump. On the contrary, if you read Business Insider, which I do from time to time, you will see that they are absolutely bought up. Strong supporters of the Democrats. They have been strong supporters of the Russiagate theory. So, they are clearly investigating all of this. They've found these witnesses. These witnesses, they sound absolutely convincing to me. I mean, obviously, I don't know much about them, but presumably one of them, they have been, looked at by Business Insider, and they're coming forward and they're giving their names. We're not talking about anonymous witnesses here. We're talking about people who have been prepared to go out and tell their story and do so in the knowledge that they're going to be criticized and attacked by all kinds of people for doing it. So, and the details of the story that they're giving seem to be fairly consistent with each other in a way that suggests that what they're saying is indeed true. So, I mean, lots of things to say here. I have to make one further point, which is again, the case that I always go back to is the Brett Kavanaugh case. And the most extraordinary thing about the Brett Kavanaugh case was that there was no corroboration for Dr. Ford's story at all. If you remember, in that particular case, it was a sexual assault that was supposed to have happened at a student party between Brett Kavanaugh and Dr. Ford, which he wasn't, of course, Dr. Ford then. None of the people at that party remembered anything, and none of the people remembered Dr. Ford complaining about it at the time. And yet the media ran with it and acted as if it was true. And the Democrats made a huge play of it during Kavanaugh's the hearings to confirm him, the confirmation hearings. This, by contrast, now is we're starting to get an accumulation of evidence that corroborates the complaint that has been made against Biden. One, a contemporaneous film, television film, of a complaint by the victim's mother to Larry King, which has been caught on CNN. And now we have these two other witnesses. I would say this was pretty impressive. And what they're describing, beyond a no doubt about it, is a very serious sexual assault. We're not, this is what they're describing is a straightforward criminal offense.
I think they got him. I think they got him. We need to continue to be patient and wait
We
for
need to
all the
be
facts to
patient
come
for,
out. But I don't think Biden's going to make it. My
Well,
opinion. That's just my
I
opinion.
have to say, I mean, let's say something like this had come out against Bernie Sanders, though I don't believe that he would have done. He would have been out. I mean, this would have been the end of him. It may be the end of Biden. It should be the end of Biden. This is a serious criminal defense. We're not talking about, somebody, putting their hands on a shoulder, which can, by the way, be very inappropriate in itself, but we're not
Which
talking about.
he's on video. He's on video doing it many, many
Many,
times.
many times, exactly. But that can be a serious thing, but not necessarily a criminal offense. This is a clear criminal offense. And 1993, well, it's a fair amount of time ago. What happened to Brett Kavanaugh was in the early 80s, a whole decade earlier. So, just keep remember that, because for me, that's the comparator, if you like, with the way the Democrats handled one allegation and they're trying to cover up this one. But it's important we have here, by the way, interesting that one of the witnesses is a very strong Democrat or self-describes as a very strong Democrat. And it's interesting also that it's Business Insider, which is, as I said, a pro-Democrat mainstream media outlet. I mean, it's not pro-Republican, not pro-Trump. So maybe the net is closing on Joe Biden.
Yeah, and let's not forget that the 1993 incident for Biden, we have it on video. We
We
never had any such thing with Kavanaugh.
no, we're nothing like that on
We
Kavanaugh at
have the
all.
corroborating evidence. Let me
We
rephrase that, the corroborating evidence
evidence
on video.
on video. Well, we
Yes.
have indeed, and we have now. I mean, I would have said, by the way, that this evidence that we've seen, I'm not saying he should be prosecuted. It's not my decision to make. I think there is enough evidence here to mount a prosecution. I think, my opinion.
Definitely an investigation.
Definitely an investigation.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. We'll leave it there and we'll wait for more news to break. My hunch is a lot more people are going to come forward. That's my hunch. I'm starting to feel that the dam is about to break on the Bidens. And I say the Bidens because remember you have a Hunter Biden as well in there and his antics in Ukraine. But anyway, any final words, Alexander, before we
Well,
end it?
two quickly things. If this can't be blamed on the Republicans, it can't be blamed on Donald Trump. As I said, Business Insider is not aligned with them. That is one. The second is that, of course, and I have to bring this up, it goes very much with your theory that there was never any real intention to run with Biden at all. I'm not going to develop that further. But I cannot believe that people in the DNC were not aware that there were problems with Biden of this sort. So, I mean, let's bear that in mind too.
I'm sure all of Washington knew,
I'm
or a lot
sure
of
the
the
world.
insiders in Washington knew.
I'm sure every single insider in Washington knew, and that includes most of the media also.
Yeah. All right. We'll leave it there and we'll wait for more news to come out on this story. Thank you, Alexander.